ओके फातिमा, नाउ यू कैन से व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय रेस्पिरेशन?
यस मैम, टेकिंग इन ऑक्सीजन फ्रॉम द एयर एंड गिविंग आउट कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड.
ओके वेरी गुड. व्हाट डू यू कॉल फॉर द सिस्टम, योर ऑर्गन सिस्टम व्हिच डू रेस्पिरेशन आर हियर? व्हाट डू यू कॉल फॉर दैट सिस्टम?
रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम.
रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम. ओके प्रणव, कैन यू टेल मी द process which is included in respiration?
Yes ma'am.
What you call for the process which is included in respiration?
Ma'am, respiration.
There's a process which is included. What is that?
Taking in oxygen.
Taking in oxygen. What you call for that? One word Pranav.
Breathing.
Yeah, breathing. Breathing is the process which is involved in respiration. Okay. Now, did we discuss about what is the use of respiration in our life?
Ma'am, we need oxygen.
Yes. Tell. No problem. Tell. Tell me.
Ma'am, yes, we need oxygen in our daily life.
For what we require?
For energy.
Okay, good. Can you read now? The first one. Who is that? Rihan. Rihan is joined. Or who said just now? Our person.
Paul Hansel,
can you see the slide, Paul?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you read the first one? This is the importance of respiration. Okay, can you read that?
How is the
energy? You can't see it.
Yes, ma'am.
Read. Energy. Okay, energy
stored in food.
Food released
to be used by the
body. Okay, can you read the next line, please? I'll allow. Let Paul at least read at least 1, 2, 3 sentences. Otherwise, he will not learn. No, Paul? Read. Next, what is the answer? Can you see the slide, Paul?
You know that
during the
period
process.
During the process of
Breathing
was take.
We take in air. Okay, good. Okay, Paul. Pranav, can you continue with it?
Yes, ma'am.
Continue. You know
oxygen is taken in while carbon dioxide is released out of the body during breathing. Oxygen is then circulated to all cells of the body. Glucose is broken down. Cells with the help of oxygen.
That's enough, Pranav. Let me explain. So this is the importance of respiration in our life. What's the importance? In order to broken down the food, or to break the food down in the cells with the help of oxygen. Okay, so you know, during the process of breathing, we take in air, oxygen is taken in, while carbon dioxide is released out of the body. During breathing, oxygen then circulated all cells of the body, and food is broken down in the cells with the help of oxygen. So this is the use of respiration in our life. So instead of writing entire thing, I'll tell you what is the use of respiration. Can you write this? Use of respiration in our life. Use of respiration. Use or importance. Use of respiration in our life. first point. During respiration, we take oxygen in through breathing and release carbon dioxide. Okay. Second point, after releasing carbon dioxide, what happens? The oxygen breaks down the food or glucose, because food is stored in the form of glucose. The oxygen breaks down the food or glucose in our cells and release energy. So whatever we have written, I have given 2 points. That is, during respiration, we take in oxygen and release carbon dioxide. The oxygen breaks down the food or glucose in our cells and release energy. So this was the use of respiration. So this energy, what happened to this energy? This energy is utilized for various life activities. So if I ask you, what is the importance of respiration, or what is the use of respiration in our life, you have to write these 3 points. So it may be the 3 marks question, you have to write all the 3 points. Okay, so I repeat.
Okay, first onwards.
Yeah, 1 minute, let me just scroll it down. Okay. Okay. So during respiration, we take oxygen in through breathing and release carbon dioxide. The oxygen breaks down the food.
Our glucose in our cells and
Release energy. And what happened to this energy?
This energy is utilized.
Okay, various life activities. Okay. Yes, have you completed?
Yes.
Everyone?
No, ma'am, 1 minute. I won't finish.
Okay.
Ma'am, can you show the last one?
Last one? Okay. Can you see now? Shall I rub the board?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. I think first thing you are... One minute. Let me take it up.
Ma'am, then if you rub, ma'am, I will click a screenshot.
Okay, fine. Okay. Now we are moving, because of this breaking down of glucose is taking place in our cells, we call this respiration as cellular respiration. What does we call? Cellular respiration. So next step, next heading, you can write cellular respiration. So the same respiration, we can call it another name, since it is taking place in our cells, because cell is the tiny unit. Okay, so we call it cellular respiration. Now we will see, what do you mean by cellular respiration? Okay. So the second line, okay, the second line, what do you mean by cellular respiration? Is for one mark answer we can write. So the second line, Irene, can you read the second paragraph? So first is already over, second paragraph.
Yes ma'am. The process in which food is broken down in the cells to release energy is known as cellular respiration.
Okay, very good. The process in which food is broken down in the cells to release energy. So if I ask you, define the term cellular respiration, you have to write only these sentences. The process in which food is broken down in the cells to release energy. Okay? Yes.
Then we can do is called.
Yeah. Either you can write is called, is known as. Both are correct. Okay, have you completed? Yes. Okay. I hope, yeah. So now we are going to see how many types of cellular respiration take place. So cellular respiration can take place in two ways. Okay, so that is what we are going to, first we have learned what do you mean by respiration, the use of respiration, and now come to the types of cellular respiration. So you can write on the board or in your lecture note, types of cellular respiration. Types of cellular respiration. The first type, we call it aerobic respiration. Aerobic respiration. Aerobic respiration. And second one, anaerobic. It's a one word. Okay. It is not using article below that, behind that. No, it is a one word. Anaerobic respiration. So these are the two types of cellular respiration. Aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. Shall we go to the separately? You are going to learn what do you mean by aerobic respiration. I hope everyone has written that. Okay. Arun Swami, can you read in the slide the third paragraph? Don't write what is on the slide. I'll give you in symbol method.
Okay, yeah. Ma'am.
This is some of the important points regarding the aerobic respiration. Okay, Arun Swami, proceed.
Two types of respiration take place in the cells. One occurs in the presence of oxygen, while the other occurs in the absence of it. The process of breakdown of food, the presence of oxygen, is known as aerobic respiration. Mm. It takes place in all organisms and leads to the production of carbon dioxide. Mm. Water and energy.
Mm. Then glucose.
Glucose, oxygen, carbon dioxide, plus water, its energy.
Okay, children, don't write anyone. I just explain to you. So what do you mean by from this paragraph, Aaron? You only tell me. From this you will get a point. What do you mean by aerobic respiration? What is that, Aaron? In the slide itself, that point is given.
Ma'am, it says like one occurs in the presence of oxygen.
While the other
occurs in the absence of
oxygen. Okay. In the presence of oxygen, which respiration takes place?
Aerobic, ma'am.
Aerobic respiration. Okay. So aerobic respiration, everyone please mute it because some sound. So aerobic respiration takes place in the presence of oxygen. So when we breathe in, oxygen we take in, and oxygen will break down the food or glucose and release energy. That process is known as aerobic cellular respiration, or simply we'll say aerobic respiration. So you can see the last Aaron has read some glucose, carbon dioxide, this is and all. Actually, it is a chemical equation. So this is actually a chemical equation. Chemical equation. So see, it is a chemical process. Digestion, eating, and also respiration. All these are a chemical process because it is involved the presence of some of the chemical component. In the first chapter, we have learned another process. Do you remember which is that chemical process? We talk about carbon dioxide and all nutrition in plants. What is that? What do you call for that process? Adi, are you in the class, my dear?
CO2 plus H2.
Okay, what do you call? What is that equation for which process?
Photosynthesis.
Photosynthesis also is a chemical process. There also you have learned an equation. So here also we are learning equation, that is glucose. And what is this arrow indicate? Gives. Glucose oxygen. Gives. In the oxygen. Presence of what?
Oxygen.
Oxygen is written on the top of it. The meaning is glucose breaks down or gives in the presence of oxygen. What are the things? I am writing in short form carbon dioxide. CO2 you already learned in the previous chapter. Water plus energy.
Okay.
So okay. This is a chemical equation. So glucose breakdown or react with the oxygen. Chemistry we call reaction, no? Glucose react with oxygen and we are getting carbon dioxide, water, energy. And you remember, I have given the chemical equation of glucose in that chapter. Anyone remember this C6H12O6?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes. Actually, this glucose is this. So,
ma'am, after... C6H12O6.
C means carbon. H means hydrogen, O means oxygen. So 6 carbon atoms, 12 hydrogen atoms, and 6 oxygen atom. These
and
three.
It's one glucose molecule.
It's one glucose molecule. But in our body, there is a plenty of glucose molecules. Okay. So this will again react with the oxygen what we receive through breathing. And it breaks down. And what are the things we release? One is carbon dioxide. That is what we breathe out. We breathe out carbon dioxide. Then in our body, there will be some water content. That is why you go for number one. And also not only necessary, water also necessary to digest to the food. Plus energy. So same component, glucose will be turned into carbon dioxide, water, and remaining is energy. Water, do you remember that chemical equation? H2O. One water molecule is 2 hydrogen atom, 1 oxygen atom. Okay. So that is why. So aerobic respiration, this is the summary. If you represent in a chemical equation, this is the summary of aerobic respiration. Glucose, oxygen gives carbon dioxide plus water plus energy. Now you can write the definition of aerobic. Have you written the definition, all of you?
Ma'am, which one? Aerobic.
Okay, so you can write the definition. The process of, on the slide it is there, but I think it is blurred. So I'm writing on the board. The process of, when I make it big, it is going to be a little blurred. Okay, so process of breakdown of food. food means what? Bracket, you can write glucose. Glucose in the presence of oxygen. In the presence of oxygen. Okay, in the presence of oxygen is called or known as aerobic respiration. See children, you are learning lot of new words, okay? So when you come on Monday, last chapter, acid and base, I will be sending a set of dictation words, some new words you have learned in that, okay? So some dictation words I will be giving you, so you have to study that. Similarly, after I finish this chapter also, we are learning so many new scientific terms. Okay, dictation will be there. Monday, you have only last chapter, acid bases.
Ma'am, can we write that equation, the chemical equation?
Yes. Okay. Shall I write on the top? So, glucose gives oxygen.
And it is there on the board, ma'am.
It is there, but for some of them, it is very difficult to see. That is why. Maybe due to network issues. Carbon dioxide plus water. I think aerobic everyone has written, no? So I'm just rubbing the first line. Water plus energy. And those who want to write in fully chemical equation, you can write if you want. O6. Oxygen, O2. One oxygen molecule is O2. This is actually the pakka. Pakka means real carbon dioxide. CO2 plus H2O plus energy is in the form of, it is visible. So it has no chemical name. So it's a part of physics, energy. Whatever work you do, you are able to do because of that invisible strength. You can say energy is the measure of the strength. How do you use? So it doesn't have any chemical equation, okay? So this is, if I make this into fully chemical equation, this is what? C6H12O6 gives O2, CO2 plus H2O plus energy. And in chemistry, we call this as reactants. Reactants, which are those? C6H12O6 and O2, oxygen. These are known as reactants, and all this what we produce. In chemistry, we call it products. So after undergoing reaction or change, you are getting three products, carbon dioxide, water, and energy. Yes. Okay. So now we are moving on to the next one. I hope everyone completed. Anaerobic respiration. Aerobic in the presence of oxygen. Aaron, you read it. While other in, what did you read?
Ma'am, the absence of oxygen.
So you can get the definition of anaerobic respiration. Now next heading. Anaerobic respiration. It's the second type of cellular respiration. Anaerobic respiration. The process of, same thing. Only thing, instead of in the presence, you can only write in the absence of oxygen. That is the difference between definition of aerobic and anaerobic. Okay, the process of breakdown of, I'm writing glucose directly because everyone knows glucose food, another form of food. The process of breakdown of glucose in the absence of, so you, everyone who study definition of aerobic, when you study that, if in the exam, if I ask you anaerobic, you only have to change this word, in the absence of oxygen. Oh, absence of oxygen. So that is known as, I'm not writing fully, you can complete it. Oxygen is called anaerobic respiration. Now similarly, what is happening in this? Actually, anaerobic respiration takes place in muscles, not in cells. Okay. The difference between this, it takes place in muscle cells. Aerobic through our nose. But anaerobic is not taking place through the nose. It is taking place in muscle cells. Okay. It takes, that's the difference. It takes place in muscle cells. How it takes place for we human being? We also do cellular respiration. It does. Whenever you run faster, whenever you do any difficult work, what happened to your body? Anyone can tell me? That is panting. Okay. When you pant, you cannot breathe faster, correct? What else? What else? After playing and all, what do you do?
Tired.
What else? Something produce. Your body will produce something.
Sweat.
Okay. The sweating is the example of anaerobic respiration. Why do you sweat? Because your muscle cell is doing anaerobic respiration. Because whenever you run fast, whenever you play football, whenever you do any difficult activity, the nose cannot completely work or provide enough energy or enough oxygen to break down it. So your muscle cells will start respiring through it, and as a result, the production of sweat. See, nowadays doctors say those who have highly diabetic, those who are very fat or obesity problem, but the doctor said do exercise. What is this do exercise? Some of this diabetic people know what happens. They don't have the complete digestion in their body. So their body is weak. It will not do the complete digestion of the glucose. So because of that, they are unable to break down the glucose fully. So in order to have a proper digestion, the doctor will say those are diabetic patients and obesity, then those are very fat. Okay. They will say you also should do the exercise. Why? Through doing exercise, your muscle cell undergo respiration and your energy is wasted in the form of heat. You see, whenever you run, your body is started sweating. Why? Your body have a high temperature.
Yes,
no? And not only a lot of heat energy produces from your body, correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Actually, what is this heat energy? It is the extra energy, extra fat, which is in your body is converted in the form of heat energy. As a result, you produce sweat. And what is this sweat? What the nature of the sweat? Do you like to sweat?
Yeah, ma'am.
Do you like to close to a friend who is sweating so badly, which make you to not to go? What will happen? A person who sweat, the person will produce a bad smell. Do you know that? Every person body has a different type of sweating smells. Do you agree with it? Yeah. If you don't agree, you just observe your friends, your neighbors, your brothers. When you play, you just observe. Everyone has a different smell for the sweat. Because they are producing one kind of thing, what you call, that is acid, lactic acid. You produce lactic acid. It is the smell of the lactic acid which is produced after the sweat. The sweat is acidic in nature.
Ma'am, sweat has no smell, ma'am.
Ah, you don't have smell. Aaron, I don't think. Do you play? Ma'am. Aaron?
That's what I'm saying, ma'am.
No. Aaron, I think did you play games?
Like what?
Did you run faster? Did you play any games?
Ma'am, I have no friends.
You don't play?
Ma'am, I have no friends to play.
That is why. But I think Safan, Naeem, all these are athletes. No, Naeem, Safan?
Ma'am, yes, I can't play, ma'am. I'm in a different country.
Okay. I know you are in Gulf country, you cannot play outside, no? Only indoor games also. That is why you are not understanding. You are always in AC. Is it so, Aaron?
Ma'am, no, like I was in India and I came here for visa purposes. I'll be back in India pretty soon.
Ah, okay. But if you are in Gulf country, you know your entire room is AC air conditioned. There you don't sweat. You don't sweat. Okay. But you come to Kerala, just walk under the sun, that's enough. You started sweating, and also some of them have a bad smell of it because it's a smell of lactic acid. Have you ever observed whenever you sweat under your armpit, there's a yellowish color on your clothes? Some of them, not all. Maybe you are not more acidic, but especially there are people who has got a hot body by nature. Hot body means they simply sweat. Even they don't do action. Simply, if now I am sitting and talking over there, standing and talking, sometimes I sweat because of the heat energy of this studio light. Okay. So, some people, when they sweat, you look at the armpit, your cloth, you know, which is under your armpit, it will have a yellowish color.
I mean, we wear white dress, we can
especially white dress. When you wear white dress, it is very visible. Why? You know, it is producing an acid. That acid is reacting with the cloth, because cloth is by nature, it has base. So that is why there's a color change in your cloth. Just observe. Next. So that is the reason of anaerobic. This is because of you are sweating. So now we are coming to the chemical equation of anaerobic respiration. We are almost two more, I think, running short, but we can complete this. Yeah. So this is the chemical reaction. Glucose, which glucose? In muscle cell. Muscle is a cell. So I am writing glucose in muscle. Absence of oxygen. Here you should write absence of oxygen. I am not writing full oxygen. I am writing O2. O2 means oxygen molecule, and what you will get? Lactic acid plus energy. Lactic acid plus energy. Okay, so this is the chemical equation of anaerobic respiration. Okay. And some of the organism also produce, there are two ways of, another also produce, not only lactic acid every time. So there are two equations. First one, so those who have completed writing the first equation, you can also write or. In the absence of oxygen, it also produces alcohol. Alcohol plus carbon dioxide plus energy. So anaerobic respiration can be two ways. One is in muscles. When it takes place in muscles, okay. Sometimes instead of lactic acid, it will produce alcohol, carbon dioxide and energy. There are two equations. One is glucose, lactic acid plus energy. Another one, glucose in the absence of air, not human being. Okay. This happens in the second equation. What I told, this happens in some microorganisms. not in human being. Not in human being. Human being is what I wrote in the first. Absence of oxygen, lactic acid plus energy, that is our sweat. This happens. Glucose in the absence of oxygen, alcohol plus carbon dioxide happens. In which microorganism? Yeast. Okay. The yeast is a microorganism. In yeast, anaerobic respiration takes place. It produces an alcohol. That is what we are using yeast for wine and what you call appam, for appam, you know. Okay, the especially the Keralites, they make a special appam. They put yeast in it in order to ferment the flour. Okay, so yeast is mainly used for wine and appam. Why? Because it produces, yeah, their body produces an alcohol. So that alcohol will ferment the food and turning into a little bit sour and little bit nice smell. You can appam, you know, the Kerala appam. Okay, children. So I am winding up the session now. So we completed aerobic and aerobic. Go through it, and next class when you come prepared, read the textbook of acid base and come for dictation. I will be sending some of the words also. Okay, thank you, children.